Hello, hello friends, hello Anna. Thank you for hosting us, our channel all about Batumi in Gonio Apsaros fortress. Hope you have very interesting tour today.
Hello, so today I will present a small presentation about this fortress. So let's start.
Okay.
This fortress, first of all, it is located in southwestern Georgia on the left bank of the mouth of the Chorohi River within 12 kilometers of Batumi city. Stronghold is built close to the sea on a strategically important site where roads leading to the eastern Black Sea littoral, and which was possible to join and connect the Armenia Minor and eastern Georgia, which is called also Iberia as well. So then Apsaros had a strategic significance for Romans, then Byzantians and Ottomans. Yes, of course.
Tell us about the name Apsaros and tell us about the legends or maybe some stories which people preserved for us. And how is it related to Argonauts?
The origin of Apsaros is connected to the legend of Argonauts and so according to the later version of this legend, so we all know this myth, so I will try to highlight more important details in this myth. So Medea has helped with Jason's band in order to steal the golden fleece from the sacred grove of Ares. Then so when they stole this, after this Colchians caught up their bands, and then on advice of Medea, Jason invited Absyrtus, brother of Medea, into his ship, then killed him, cut up his limbs and threw into the sea. And then Colchians, according to some evidence, some sources and surveys, so Colchians collected these parts of the body of Absyrtus and transported them to the place where Gonio stands now.
Okay, Anna, tell us about the fence. What is it made of, and what about the size of the fence?
So this fortress is rectangular in plan, which means that its length 222 meters, its width 195 meters, the total length of the walls in perimeter 900 meters, height of the walls 5 meters, and so on. So originally in the past, the fortress had 4 entrances and 22 towers, but nowadays we have only 18 towers and only the western gate is opened. Other gates and other entrances are bricked up. At the dawn of the 19th century, so richly ornamented door was fully preserved at the main entrance, but according to Professor Krasno, it was taken away by foreign archaeologists, and so entrances facing each other point to the existence of two intercrossing streets, and also every side of this fortress was protected by something. So for instance, the west side was protected by the sea. Why sea? Because it was the safest way of retreat. Then to the east it was protected by the mountains, to the west, to the north it was protected by the river, and the only south side was unprotected by something. So it is the main reason why the walls on this side are mostly reinforced.
You said about the Roman military, so there were soldiers. Can you tell us the number of the soldiers?
Yes, sure. So according to some evidence, surveys, some sources, we know that in this area, in this fortress, there were approximately 1,500 Roman soldiers and 5 additional cohortas. So they were using this area in order to fight from there. Then in order to live there, they were making some
defense.
Yes, and so it was it had also defense significance, and also they were living there and using these camps properly.
So Anna, a part of strategic and military purposes, what other purposes serve Gonio Fortress?
So thus, in the first half of the second century, there were theater and hippodrome. It was a large city full of some activities like horse riding, wrestling, and so on. So it was not only a military strategic point. So it was a city full of some interesting, fascinating performances.
Entertainment?
And, yes, yes, race. Yes. So Romans were funny people. So what about their kitchen? There was not any sugar in the kitchen of Romans.
Really?
Yes. Only sweetie was honey, and they were using some cookies, sweeties, double baked cookies with honey. Posca was a popular drink among the ancient Roman soldiers, so it was made by water and wine, mixing this water and wine together, then added some spices and a bit vinegar too. Also, and what about their recipe? So, according to some sources, in their daily ration included bread, oil, olive oil, and water, and some also permanent ingredients. Mm-hmm. played an important role in their health and so on. So
they to keep them strong.
Yeah, yes, yes. And they were eating with their fingers. There was not any fork. Yes. Mm-hmm. And they were using knife in order to cut some meat.
As you mentioned, Roman militaries, they did not use forks or spoons, but as we know, we have some artifacts and we have a museum here. Could you show us this museum?
Yes, there is a little museum right there. So it was found 1994, and it is full of some remains, materials which are found and discovered there. So kitchenware dated first, third centuries. Again, clay materials, clay remains, and it is from Roman period. So the daily life of legionaries, first, third centuries, some clay pipes, clay lamps, and so on. So amphors that are dated first, third centuries. This coin, which is coin of emperor, some Roman amphors, and treasure of Gonio dated second, third centuries. This treasure is not here. It is an archaeological museum and it is preserved in special room. Child's grave dated 5th century BC. So in this child's grave we have stones, silver, gold, bronze items, some bracelets, some chests, beans, and so on. What's the place system, which is dated first, third centuries. So this water cistern was connected water system with these clay pipes. It was very good for preserve some water in hot condition, in cold condition. Mm-hmm.
These vessels are also from Roman period?
Yes, but mixing some Romans, Byzantines, and Ottomans.
So. Of course, they have a crosses, yes?
Yes, but it is not from our fortress.
Uh-huh. This is from Helvetiauri municipality.
Simonet,
yes.
Excavations in Simonet. Mm-hmm.
So we have a map here from Argonautica.
Yes.
It is very old map, yeah.
Yes, and it's the ship of Argo.
Uh-huh. This is the map of Italian geographer, yes?
Yes, Roman geographer.
Can you tell us what is there and why this map is so important for us?
So it is dated 4th century, so it is made by Roman geographer, and in this map we have fortress, fortification of Gonio Apsaros, in the middle of this map.
Mm-hmm. What can you tell us about this grave?
So this is a symbolic tomb of Saint Matthias. He was there in order to convert some wild Colchians called pagans who were against the Christian religion. So 12 August is the day of Saint Matthias. So Roman type baths, they also called thermes. So Roman they made the base of these thermes, and then Ottomans rebuilt some other construction and building top of this building. In this bath, so they had some section of hot water, section boiler room, hot water room, and other some section. There are two baths, one being small size and second one is more monumental.
So Anna, let me ask you the last question for today. Which type of services do you offer to visitors and tourists nowadays?
So visitors have real possibility to get detailed information about this fortress from our local guides in Russian, Georgian, and English language, in English languages. So then in summer, Roman festival is holding there. So there are some interesting activities, and every visitor can come there and see this original fortification from Roman period. So
so nice and beautiful.
Yes,
thank you. It was really incredible, interesting tour. Thank you for this journey through the centuries.
Thank you too.
Thank you.